Hi, buddy. You want to come see me? Come on. I'm getting ready to shed, Mom. Hey. Hi, sweetheart. Yep, he's just tolerating me, can't you tell? Hi, bud. What up? Just tolerating me. Chewy has grown so much this winter. And you know, in the winter, they tend not to grow as much because they aren't as active. Now, mine go outdoors all spring and summer, so they have a lot of activities. So to make up for the loss of those activities, I bring them out in the house a lot. So they still have that interaction with people. So they're definitely really active snakes. I always feed mine a lot right around October because I know the ones that don't go off food actually do slow down on eating. And they still get a lot of activities in the winter time in my house. So I make sure they have all the nutrients and a good supply of food in them. So they're not using up their weight and losing weight and getting bored. You know, that cracks me up. People go, my snakes are content. They just lay around in their enclosure all the time. Of course they do. What else are they gonna do if you don't ever take them out? You can't expect them to have a super strong feeding response or to be hungry a lot if they're not having any activities. It's not that your snakes are always content because they lay around. It's because it's a lifestyle they got used to because they never get to come out. Here, let's put the legs up. There you go. So it's up to you how much time you want to invest with them. You're not getting my coffee. No, you're not. No coffee for you. No? But, you know, of course they're going to lay around. If they don't have a lot of room in their enclosure to move around and get exercise, what else are they supposed to do? It doesn't particularly mean they're content. It means they're bored to death. Snakes don't sit in one spot all their lives out in the wild. Why would you expect them to do that in a captive environment? Hey, what up? Yep, you're just tolerating me, right? There's so many misconceptions about snakes. It just blows my mind. And you know, you're gonna have 100 different opinions from 100 different people. It's up to you to do research and decide who you want to believe. And you know, if you can see it, then you know it's really happening. These animals do like to be around people, and they like to interact with people. Huh. So yeah, we do. People are crazy. See, we don't have any issues with that. But yeah, I'm going to be busy in about 60 days or so. I've got gravid female corn snakes. So yeah. I'm going to have to buy me another incubator. I've got two. I'm going to have to buy me a third one. But I've already found homes for a lot of them. So if anybody's interested, let me know. And I'll put you on a waiting list for them. But they are. The female is Candy Cane, Creamsicle, and Coral. And the father of them is Albino, Snow, and Caramel. So I'm going to have there's quite a bunch of genetics going on there. And they all have beautiful colors. The last three clutches I produced were just gorgeous snakes. So if anybody wants any in the future, as soon as they hatch out, let me know and I'll put your name down for them. And I don't charge for my snakes. I can't do it with a clear conscience. So I just ask that people pay for the shipping box and the insulation and everything that goes with it and the cost of shipping, which isn't really much at all. But I don't charge people for my snakes because that's not why I let them breed. One, I let them breed because that's what they do in the wild. You know, I don't do it unless I'm sure I can give the babies a good home. You leave the cornflakes alone. That's what my boyfriend Dennis calls them, cornflakes, because they're so hyper. You're not getting on my shelves. No, no you're not. But he's just humongous. He got really big over the winter. Oh, stop it. Stop it. No. No. You gotta flip your coat, Goofy. Let's turn you around. But yeah, he's tolerating me, can't you tell? He's due to shed probably this week or next week. So is Jade. So I'm going to put them back together and hopefully we'll get some baby coastal carpet pythons out of these two. She's calmed down a lot since I've been working with her all winter. So she's not as controlling as she used to be. Those are corn snakes. Oh, you're just so curious. Yes, you are. And you're getting huge and heavy. You can't go in there. You'll get your head stuck, buddy. You'll get your head stuck in there. But yeah, I haven't been doing a whole lot of videos lately because I've been very busy here at home getting ready for snakes, watching the ones that are breeding. It's really time consuming if you dedicate yourself to it and invest a lot of time taking care of your snakes. Me, I'm on the spot. I don't leave excreted waste in my enclosures. Sorry, I had to turn him around. I don't leave stale water in my enclosures. I don't leave dirty substrate in the ones that I do use substrate in. But I got some of that Herptopia substrate. It's coconut. That stuff is just awesome. It stays moist. It's really soft. And my snakes just love it. The corn snakes I put in their enclosures. First time I've ever used it, Brian Barchek mentioned it in one of his videos, and if you get a chance to buy some, by all means do. It's fantastic stuff. I'm definitely going to stick with it. It stays a lot more moist than Aspen ever did. And I just can't say enough good things about it. It's really a fabulous product for your snakes. But yeah, I'm just rambling on. The sun's shining and it's 7 below here. So this is an indoor day for all of us today. Where are you going? You just tolerating me? Oh, dear. Oh, dear. He's just tolerating me. Huh. You hate people, don't you? Can't you tell? You're going to flip. You're going to flip us over here. He's determined to get over there and see my corn snakes. Go ahead. You get your head stuck on that rack over there. You can't do that. Sunshine, and it's deceptive, isn't it? These guys are so eager to go back outdoors, and it's probably going to be another month before they can. Oh, God, we're just so curious. That's not aggression. That's curiosity. A snake comes toward you. It's just coming toward you out of curiosity to check you out. But if it feels threatened by you, that's probably a whole different ballgame you're dealing with then. But 9 out of 10 times, they will try to get away from you and avoid you. At least they're smart enough to stay away from people out in the wild. Give them credit for that. Look at him beside my hand. Well, here's his back. This is my sweetheart. This is my sweetheart. Yep. But this is what he does. Comes out. Sits in the plastic tote, looks around, checks everything out, gets on me, gives me kisses, and goes roaming around again for a while, and then he'll come back to me and give me kisses again. But that's just tolerating me. What are you doing, silly? No, you can't go on the floor. The floor's chilly today. It's cold outside. No floor for Chewy. There's a tail end over there. Hey. Hey, Butter, what are you doing? He is humongous. Plugged up ears. Everybody around this area has had cold symptoms and flu symptoms. Plugged up ears, bad sinuses, headaches, aching all over. It's terrible. There's so many. Everybody get flu shot and end up with the flu around here. I'm like, well, I must have had a bad batch go out because it didn't do a lot of good. But, you know, it all depends on how much time you invest in your snakes. If you're not going to handle them, you're not going to know that they're social animals. I just can't see them spending their lives living it out, sitting inside of a snake enclosure. That just boggles me. Why anybody let their snakes live like that? Breeders is one thing because they don't keep them. except for breeding purposes normally. Of course, they have their favorites that they have that are considered their pets and family members. But, you know, I hate the word hobbyist, but that's what people are that aren't breeders that raise snakes. What are you doing? You can't go over there. Leave my corn snakes alone. Or as Dennis would say, my corn flakes. You're really big. Yes, you're really big. Yes, you are. Look at that face. That's a pretty face. Yes, it is. But I've been real busy here. I've got 24 double-wide sheets of plywood outside. So that's killing me because I want to get to work on that outside boa cage and get the glass roof taken down and upgrade it. And I'm building a big storage shed outside this spring to throw all my plastic snake totes in. I keep a big supply of them in case I ever have an emergency situation here and have to evacuate them from the house. And that's something people should think about. Always have a plan in case of something going wrong that you didn't expect. It's very important. Their lives depend on you. They have to come first. Hey, handsome, what are you doing? So I'm just looking at everything, dying to get into something. What? What up? The sun's beautiful today, but it's cold as heck out there. And these guys are bugging because they want to go outdoors so bad. You can't yet. Head wobble, head wobble. Stevie Wonder, I call him. Head's always going from side to side, looking everything over. Just curious, that's all. I had people ask me if I'm nervous handling them as big as they are. Absolutely not, because we have a strong bond with each other. We trust each other. Always have, since they were little babies. So, no, I don't have a problem with it. And it doesn't concern me getting bit by them, because I know them well enough as individuals to know if they're upset about something, then you just stay away from them. It's common sense. If I am having a bad day or don't feel good, I won't even take them out, and I won't handle them. I won't open their enclosures except to pat them once in a while. But you got to use your head with these guys, because they have different days, you know, different moods like people do. I can't stress that enough. For some dumb reason, people seem to think all snakes are the same and they all act the same, and they by no means do. They're as individual as people are. Chewy, you're just all over today. You can't get my coffee. No coffee, dude. He loves my vanilla creamer. I've had to fight him for my cup of coffee over here beside me on the headboard. Not literally, but it was a real job trying to keep his nose out of it. Now where are you going? So I'm going over here now. I still got slippers on. It's cold today. What are you doing? He's real dark. He's getting ready to shed. Probably this week or next week, tops. No. Turn you back around again. Wiggle worm. Back to the corn snakes again. Let's see how well I know you. No. What? What are you after now? So I don't know. I'm just looking at everything. You can flip my toad over. Yes, you are. No, you're not going over there. Oh, come on. Ugh. Come on, Chewy. Ugh. Let's get back in. Get back in. Sorry about that. He's heavy to do with one hand. In here. Unhook your prehensile tail. He hooks that tail on everything. You stay in for now. Relax. Slow down for a bit. Look, I'm going up there to get the corn snakes. You leave my corn snakes alone. Oh my gosh. Come on. They're headstrong. They are determined. And if they get something on their mind that gets their attention, they are relentless. They will go and go and go. You might distract them for a little while, but they won't forget about it, and they'll go right back to it every time. You might think they forgot about it, but they don't. give them a few minutes to think they chilled out, and they'll turn right around and go right back after it. Look at that. You're huge. Here he goes again. See? Told you. Listen. You calm down some. Yeah. You relax. God, I remember a day when I could just throw him over my shoulder. That doesn't happen now. My knees buckle when I do that with him. He's so heavy and so big. And no, he's not overfed. He eats colossal rats every month. Nothing bigger than that. You're going to... There it goes. You flipped your tote. Now you happy? Huh? But no, he's not overfed. He eats on a regular schedule. Not per the day, but when I see him hunting food, I feed him. It's really simple. You don't have to set them up to feed them on a certain day every month because they're not always hungry at the same time on the same day each month. So that just really, I mean, it's okay if it suits you better with your schedule, but as far as they go, you gotta follow. Get down. Come on. We're not outdoors. You can't go outside yet. Huffing at me. It's getting warm. I got warm in the house today. I'm making chicken Alfredo in my slow cooker. So my kitchen's a little warmer. But I just wanted to tell you, spend some time with your snakes. Don't do it to a point that stresses them out. Because then you're defeating your purpose of socializing them. But, watch them. If they start acting stressed out, if they start getting rigid and tensing up and trying to take off and flee constantly, then you're stressing them out. So put them back in the enclosure. Mine, I love them to death. I have them out every day, pretty much. Some of them. All of them? No, I don't. Not every day. It depends on how they're acting and how I perceive them to be feeling about things health-wise and just their overall demeanor. Well, I'm going to let people go. Chewy! I got to put him back in his enclosure. I got his perch all dried out now, and his enclosure's got new papers in it and fresh water and everything, but I just want to let him, when my snakes come out to clean enclosure, they come out and spend quality time with me. That's a house rule here. It's not just out and back in without any attention or without any time being spent with them. Hey, you just tolerating me? Yeah. But this is Chewy, my big boy from BHB Reptiles. Jade's as big as he is now. She's my female that came from BHB Reptiles also. They're two beautiful, very healthy snakes. Probably two of the largest coastals I've seen around this area. Or the entire U.S., as a matter of fact. But last measured, he was 11 feet, and I assure you he's past that point now. Come on, I got stuff to do. I love you. And look at that face, in that handsome face. Say, see, she's cool. I'm going to back out of that. Yeah, real vicious animals, aren't they? Hey, handsome. See, she's got hold of me. She's not going to let me get into anything. Huh, see, Mama's not going to let me get into anything. I'm not having a good day with her. They have such amazing personalities and temperaments. But that, too, depends on the time you spend with them. They aren't born that way. By no means, they're born very defensive. But the more you spend time with them, the more you realize that they are very social. And they do have fantastic personalities and temperaments if they're used to being around people. I'm going to close out this video. I got work to do today. I'm not going outside as cold as it is. Your nose is runny. You got a runny nose? You've been huffing. Stop moving for a little while. Mom, better quit doing that. Yep, he bit me, can't you tell? He got upset with me and tried to bite me. Because I was holding his head. Not. Hey, handsome. Yeah, I got work to do, too. You're going to have to go back in your house, buddy.